to God is the best thing you could ever do.
For John truly baptized with water, but ye shall be baptized with the Holy Ghost not many days hence.
Born this way. Yeah, you was born that way. The Bible said we were born in the sin, shapen into iniquity. In sin, my mother did conceive. Yeah, you was born that way, but Jesus Christ died on the cross that you can have a new life and have it more abundantly, and you ain't got to be that way.
Is your flesh running you so much that a snack is McDonald's cause you to plant a seed?
God moves for you. You got to get selfless. You cannot practice self-preservation. If you want your marriage to grow, you cannot practice self-preservation. You got to become selfless.
It is not about being perfect. It's about every day having a heart to want to do better. When you know better, do better.
Well, you got your mind set on giving. The Bible says he gives seed to the sower, and that money will walk up to you somehow, some way. I don't care if you ain't got no job. If you ain't got no job, that money gonna walk up to you somehow, some way. Amen. The systems which he has put in place, you gotta follow it if you want it to work.
I said, giving your life to Christ is the best thing you could ever do. I'm going to tell you right now, tomorrow is not promised.
In America, it ain't 50-50. It's 100 and 100. All that other stuff is God.
I'm going to tell you how real the Bible is for anybody out there that's an atheist. I feel led to share this with you. The Bible is so accurate that it is the only book that when scientists study time, they use the Bible to set their time by. The timeline that the scientists use is BC and AD.
Come on.
Now let me go and break it down to you. Any scientist will tell you that when they use that timeline, the BC stands for before Christ. Now if he wasn't real, you wouldn't set your timeline by. After what? After the death of what? After the death of our Jesus Christ. But our Jesus Christ is living. And even the scientists got to sit up because it is the most accurate book that's ever been wrote. Ever been wrote.
His baby had heart problems, so he didn't even get to touch the baby. So he had that problem going on. Well, the baby went into surgery. They had to do open heart surgery on the baby. So when he heard this right here, the brother had to fly home. And he was scheduled to land in America at 4 o'clock that evening, and his baby come out of surgery, had been in the hospital the day before. The baby was coming out of the hospital the day he was supposed to come home. That morning, the baby got checked out of the hospital. Him and the mama went out, church, but church hit him and killed him. Killed him, dead, boom. God don't even know his kid and his wife to be is dead. You know, I'm sure he done went through all kind of trauma and stuff and announced him dead. Well, Saturday morning, me, my sister-in-law, my other sister-in-law, and some other folk was quicker than our spirit. We prayed that day it happened. We prayed for the boss, Lord, don't let this brother hate you because of this stuff going on. Well, that Saturday morning, I was down at the shop. And it just quivered me in my spirit. I said, Lord, this person can't die. Because he was just on me so heavy. And I just started praying. I began to rebuke death. I said, Lord, you said we got power to rebuke death. and you'll cause life to come back in their body. I said, I know the girl been dead. I said, I declare that this girl should wake up, her kid. What I said, wake up. I said, bring her back to life. I'll rip death off her body, and I declare your resurrection power over her body. I want you to hear this right here. Little did I know, my sister-in-laws, they was praying the same thing. They didn't know it. I said, well, we always think about them. And I thought about this scripture. We don't focus on the honey, we focus on the jack. And I said, I'm not focusing on the jack. Death is the jack, but I'm focusing on the honey. She gonna live. In my restaurant, I done had a big crowd of people. My sister-in-law called me and said, brother-in-law, you're not gonna leave this. And I said, what is it, sister-in-law? She said, this morning, at 3 o'clock this morning, this girl, she woke up out the bowl. Woo! It ain't real than that right there. Let me tell you, this is so awesome. She told me right there, I wanted to drop the phone and shout out in front of them folks, but I know they thought I was star crazy.
She was tapping from the inside.
Tapping, look at her. We thought she was in the woman. Come to find out, she'd been in the freezer for 3 days. Yeah, I'm about to tell you. Been in the freezer for 3 days. 3 days in the freezer.
Yes, sir.
And at 3 o'clock in the morning, they was getting ready. She was the next one. They were doing the autopsy. They getting ready to get her out. And all of a sudden, the autopsy got heard a knock on the back. The doctor got so scared, he ran out the place. Said, look, there's somebody knocking in there in one of them doors.
What you talking about?
Somebody knocking in there in one of them doors. I'm crazy,
right? Yes, sir.
Walked back in there and the girl was knocking, pulled a drop, the girl was alive. She was alive.
Woo-hoo!
I'm telling you, God getting ready to do something in the earth. The people hey, and the girl was alive, you know what I'm telling you? And when she come up out of the morgue, that all the cuts that they had made trying to save her life wasn't even there clean. She said, Auntie, we got to go get my car. She said, baby, we can't go get your car. Your car was totaled. It flipped 3 times.
Jesus.
She said, no, while I was up in heaven, I was talking to my grandmama and I was talking to my sister and parents, and they was holding my baby. And she said, Grandma, I'm going to stay here with y'all. She said, baby, you can't stay. She said, you got to go back.
Jesus.
I said, you got to go
back.
And so my grandmama, before she got rid of sin, that said, baby, everything that you lost, with the exception of his baby, said, it's been given back to you. I want you to hear her say, it's been given back to you. She said, my car can't be destroyed because my grandmama told me when I was in heaven that it had been given back to me. How about they went to the compound, got up there, and the car looked like it ain't never been flipped. Ain't no cuts on the car where they cut out of the car. Boy, y'all don't hear me. Everybody be tearing this camera.
Again, Heavenly Father, I ask that you come into my heart.
That you come into my heart.
Into my mind.
Into my mind.
And into my spirit.
And into my spirit.
And make me a brand new creature. And I acknowledge that I am a sinner.
And that Jesus Christ
is the Son of the Living God.
Is the Son of the Living God.
And He died.
For all my sins.
He died. That I might have.
Life.
And life more abundantly. In Jesus' name. And the Bible says right now that you're saved.